The carburetor controls the air and fuel mixture in the engine. If the engine won't start or shuts off after starting, then the carburetor could be the problem. You can rebuild the carburetor using the steps in this video. Before you begin, siphon out the gas or run the snowblower until the tank is empty. Allow the engine to cool. Position the snowblower in a well-ventilated area. Wear work gloves to protect your hands. Pull the spark plug wire off the plug. Remove the mounting screws and pull the starter switch off the bracket. Let the starter switch hang by the electrical cord. Remove the key. Pull off the choke and throttle knobs. Remove the acorn nuts that secure the carburetor to the engine. Remove the muffler shroud mounting screws. Work the engine shroud off the carburetor mounting studs. Disconnect the primer hose and stop switch wires. Remove the engine shroud. Release the hose clamp and pull the fuel line off the carburetor. Slide the choke control plate off the carburetor mounting studs and disconnect the choke linkage from the control plate and carburetor. Disconnect the throttle rod return spring and remove the throttle rod from the carburetor. Slide the carburetor off the threaded mounting posts. Place the carburetor on a clean work surface. Remove the fuel bowl mounting nut. Pull off the carburetor fuel bowl and gasket. Slide the float pin out and remove the float and float valve. Unscrew the main jet. Dump the main jet and emulsion tube out of the central column. Remove the plastic throttle stop and then pry the plastic metering plug out of the carburetor. Spray carburetor cleaner into the carburetor body, fuel bowl, and all of the small brass orifices in the carburetor. Wipe the carburetor and fuel bowl clean with a clean shop towel. Be sure that all of the brass orifices are clear of debris and varnish. Warning: never run a wire through any brass orifices to clear out varnish or debris. Place the new emulsion tube in the central column with the flat end facing the carburetor bowl. Reinstall the new main jet in the central column and tighten it. Push in the new metering plug until it's fully seated. Reinstall the throttle stop screw. Thread it in until the throttle stop screw protrudes out the other side about 1/16 of an inch. Insert the new spring on the new float valve and snap the new float valve into the new float. Attach the new float to the carburetor using the new mounting pin. Place the new bowl gasket in the channel on the carburetor body. Reinstall the bowl on the carburetor using the mounting nut. Tighten the bowl nut firmly. Install the inner carburetor gasket on the mounting posts. Slide the carburetor into the two mounting posts. Reconnect the fuel hose to the carburetor and secure it using the hose clamp. Reattach the throttle rod and throttle rod return spring to the carburetor. Install the outer carburetor gasket. Reconnect the choke push rod to the carburetor choke lever. Reconnect the other end of the choke push rod to the choke control plate lever. Slide the choke control plate over the two mounting posts and install the gasket. Pull off the muffler shroud before reinstalling the engine shroud. Remove the mounting bolts and pull off the belt cover. Remove the bolts from the red chute support bracket and pull the support bracket forward, releasing the control rod from the four-way control rod receiver. Remove the front muffler shroud mounting bolts. Release the wire control cables from the retainer clip and pull off the muffler shroud. Work the engine shroud onto the engine. Reconnect the stop switch wires. Reconnect the primer hose. Align the choke knob shaft and the two carburetor mounting posts with the openings on the engine shroud. Make sure that the breather hose passes through the opening and lines up with the rocker cover breathing hose fitting. Slide the breather hose over the rocker cover fitting and secure the hose with a clamp. Reinstall the two acorn nuts to secure the engine shroud to the engine. Slide the wire control cables into the retainer clip and position the muffler shroud on the engine. Reinstall the muffler shroud mounting bolts. Push the control rod back into the four-way control rod receiver and line up the support bracket with the mounting holes. Reinstall the bolts in the red chute support bracket. Reinstall the belt cover using the mounting bolts. Reinstall the choke and throttle knobs. Position the electric starter switch on the switch bracket and reinstall the mounting screws. Reconnect the spark plug wire to the spark plug. Push the key into the slot.